Now the next point, you must have seen in the book, they write D-glucose or L-glucose like that. Okay. So what is this D and L configuration we have of glucose? That is what we are trying to understand. So heading you write down D L configuration.
Dextrose.
D and L configuration. Okay. So for to assign this D and L configuration, we have to take a reference compound. Okay. And the reference compound we have here is glyceraldehyde. Okay. So the standard compound here, or the reference compound that we take for this purpose, is glyceraldehyde. Okay. The formula of glyceraldehyde is, it is CHO aldehyde here. OH one side, this side we have H, and here we have CH2OH. This is glyceraldehyde. Glyceraldehyde is optically active in nature. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
It is optically active.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay.
Why it is optically active? Because we have
one chiral carbon.
Chiral carbon. So there is no symmetry, optically active in nature. Okay. Now it is optically active we have. So we can also write this, formula of glyceraldehyde, OH this side, H this side, CHO and CH2OH here. Okay. So this is the Fischer projection of glyceraldehyde, right? In Fischer projection, we always try to write maximum number of carbon atom on the vertical line. Okay. That's how it is. It is a Fischer projection. Okay. So this is the reference compound we have taken. And what is the reference we have here? That in this compound, okay, this carbon is a chiral carbon, the second carbon here. If OH present on right hand side, if this OH are there on the right hand side of this carbon, then this is D-glyceraldehyde. And if OH on the left hand side, we call it as L-glyceraldehyde. That is the reference we have. On the basis of this only, we'll define glucose also, whether it is D glucose or L glucose. Okay. So now let me draw the structure of glucose again here. Okay. Equimolar mixture of these two is what? If you take the racemic equimolar mixture of these two, what you get?
Racemic mixture, optically inactive.
Mixture. And this is optically active. This is optically active. So these two also we call it as enantiomers pair of each other. Enantiomers, okay, mirror image of each other, non-superimposable, hence enantiomers. Equimolar mixture of these two is racemic mixture. Okay, so if OH on the left side, it is L, OH on the right side, it is D. That's what you keep in mind. On the chiral carbon, that's what you need to see. On the chiral carbon on the right, it is D. Now, if I draw the structure of glucose here, and that is here we have CHO, then OH on the right, H on the left, OH on the right, OH on the left. First we have right, then left, and then right. OH, OH, CH2OH. And everywhere we have hydrogen present. H here and H here. Now you see the thing is here, glucose is this. We have to see the position of OH on the chiral carbon. But in case of glyceraldehyde, we have only one chiral carbon. Okay. But here we have how many chiral carbon? 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? And if I have to number this carbon atom, what is the number of this carbon atom? Should we start from this side or this side? Anyone?
From the aldehyde side, because it has
the aldehyde side, because it is the primary principal functional group, right? So this is first carbon, this is second carbon, this one is third, this one is fourth, this one is fifth, this one is sixth. All of you understood this? This is the primary functional group. So we have to start numbering from this carbon atoms. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Like I said, we have to see the position of OH on the chiral carbon. In case of glyceraldehyde, it is very fine because we have only one chiral carbon. Here we have four chiral carbon, right? So which carbon we have to see here, right? So we'll see the carbon which is at the maximum distance from the primary functional group, which is at the maximum distance from the primary functional group. Got it? Okay. Understood? So to define whether it is D or L glucose, we have to see the position of OH on the chiral carbon, which is at the maximum distance from the primary functional group, which is nothing but this C5 carbon. Okay. So if you write this OH on the right hand side on this carbon, this is D glucose. Is it clear? This is D glucose. So we have to see it is the configuration of C5 carbon number 5. If I take this OH on the left hand side, if I write, which is suppose this one, we have CHO here, OH on the right, OH on the left, OH on the right, on the left. This side we have H here. And here we have CH2OH. Everywhere we have hydrogen. So you see on the chiral carbon, which is at the maximum distance from the primary functional group, OH is present on the left. This formula is for L glucose, not D. It's clear. Got it? D and L?
Yes, sir.
Sometimes, you know, the representation of glucose, they also ask this question. Exam mein, they have asked this question once. Okay. Like suppose at second carbon, what is the configuration we have, D or L at second carbon? This one at second carbon, what is the configuration we have? See, at second carbon, the OH is present on the right. It means it is D. So 2D. Third carbon, OH on the left.
3L.
L. 4D.
4D, 5D.
5D. So this also, they ask the representation of glucose. They'll give you this kind of four options. You have to find it out which one is the glucose, D or L. Okay. For this one, what is the representation we have? 2D,
3L, 4D,
4D, 5L. This is the representation of L glucose. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So we always see the position of OH from primary functional group. The chiral carbon, which is at the maximum distance from the primary functional group. Okay. Now, next we have to discuss here the classification of carbohydrates. Okay. Classification. Three types of carbohydrates we have mainly. Okay. three types of carbohydrate. The first one is monosaccharides. The second one is oligosaccharides. And the third one is polysaccharides. Okay, so this is Shravan, sir. Ketone group, for example, RCOR and both are the same, but less aryl carbon has different configuration. Then what do we take? I did not get it, Shravan.
Sir, send a picture of the thing on WhatsApp.
Acha, I'll see.
I'll send it after class, sir.
I'll see that. Where is my Yashwantpur ka bacha log kahan pe hai? Where is that Yashwantpur guys?
Yes, sir,
here. We're here, sir.
It's there, yes, Paras. Yes, Likid is also there.
Yes, sir. Yes, Likid didn't.
Where is Aditya?
I'm here, sir.
Okay. And what about the girls?
Yes, sir, we're here.
You're there?
Yes,
okay,
sir.
Okay, fine. So monosaccharides, monosaccharides are those are those carbohydrates which cannot be hydrolyzed further. Okay, hydrolysis is not possible for these kind of hydrides. Okay, so write down, monosaccharides are those carbohydrates which cannot be hydrolyzed further. Cannot be hydrolyzed further. Okay. For example, we have glucose,
galactose.
Yes. Fructose. Galactose, etc. All these are examples of monosaccharides. Okay. Oligosaccharides are those carbohydrates which on hydrolysis, gives 2 to 10 units of monosaccharides.
Example, sucrose.
10 units of monosaccharides. Example.
Sucrose.
Who is this?
Sir, Santosh.
Santosh.
Sucrose, sir.
Can you mute the first, please?
H3O plus. Sucrose on hydrolysis gives 1 unit of glucose. This you must remember. Hydrolysis of sucrose gives 1 unit of glucose and 1 unit of fructose. This also they have asked in the exam.
Sir, maltose gives you 2 glucose, right?
Maltose gives 2 glucose, yes. Formula of sucrose is C12H22O11. Second example, we have maltose.
Sir, there's something which gives glucose and galactose, right?
Lactose.
Yes. There are other students also, guys. H3O plus. Maltose on hydrolysis gives 2 unit of glucose. All of you must remember this. What we get on hydrolysis of these oligosaccharides. Okay. Lactose. Lactose molecular formula is again same. C12H22O11. On hydrolysis, it gives 1 unit of glucose and 1 unit of galactose. Okay, so how do we know this? See, in all these molecules, glucose is common. If you have sucrose, you'll get fructose, lactose, galactose, and for maltose, we have only glucose. Got it? Another thing here is, like, you must have heard about disaccharides, trisaccharides, right? What are disaccharides? You can define this as we are defining monosaccharides, right? Disaccharides are those carbohydrates which on hydrolysis gives two monosaccharides. Got it? So disaccharides, trisaccharides, since this oligosaccharides contains 2 to 10 units. Okay? So disaccharides is within this oligosaccharides. Trisaccharides within this oligosaccharides. Tetra oligosaccharides. Okay? So all these are sucrose, maltose, lactose are the example of what? Yes? Are the example of disaccharides. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Disaccharides. Why it is disaccharides? Because on hydrolysis they are giving two units. That's why it is disaccharides. Similarly, if on hydrolysis they give three units, it is trisaccharides and so on, which is not important. What not you don't have to keep that in mind. Okay. Now, 2 to 10 units are oligosaccharides. 1 unit if you have monosaccharides. What is polysaccharides then? Which gives more than 10 units of monosaccharides. Polysaccharides are those carbohydrates which on hydrolysis gives more than 10 units of monosaccharides. For example, we have cellulose, starch,
glycogen.
Yes, starch, glycogen,
agarose.
Yes, so all these are polysaccharides. Copy it down. Can we go to the next page? Let me know.
Yes, sir.
All of you have done?